Well, good morning, YouTubers. It's your boy, Coach Doug, and another episode of PNW Trout Slayer. What does PNW stand for? Pacific Northwest. I get asked that all the time, especially people who live out here. I'm like, PNW, Pacific Northwest. But I'm out here on Offutt Lake this morning. There is a lot of people out here. Got pulled up, and there was already four boats in there. Excuse me. It's not COVID. But anyways, I already had four boats. I had already launched. Had another guy getting in his little blow-up raft. And then another guy pulled up next to me with a canoe. And looks like there's about three or four people over there at the dock on the resort side. And I don't know if any of the people on the lake that live here are out here, but to me, that is a busy lake. So a couple weeks ago, they stocked some more jumbo trout in here. It's the whole reason why I came here today. I was going to head down to Vance Creek, Pond 2. They just got done stocking the late winter steelhead down there. But I was like, you know what? Let me get the Offutt Lake trip out of the way. So my plans for this year, for when I do episodes, is every episode that I do is going to be a different lake. I'm not going to have, like I've already done Lake St. Clair with my daughter. That was episode one for season three. And then I dropped a Nothing But a Hits episode two. That's all the other outings that I did, but didn't make episodes out of them, but I still wanted you guys to see the catches. So I'm going to be doing that a lot lately, because I will come back out on Offutt Lake, but I will just show you the catches on that. So today's episode will be episode three, and then the next episode after that will be another Nothing But the Hits. And then when next month come around, I'll have a different lake. Nothing But the Hits, and I might have a couple cooking tutorials in between. Well, that's the rundown for this year, so that when you guys tune in, be a different lake every time. I'm trying to get my boy Brian out here. He said soon, so can't wait to get you out here, bro. Seeing all this fun. It is a little windy today. It's supposed to have been partly sunny, but No. Same thing as yesterday. It was supposed to be partly sunny, but it actually drizzled on everybody. So I stayed home and did chores. Got caught up on some of my back work at the house. And finally, today, the tow truck is coming to pick up Big Sexy, the Flex. Get it fixed from what happened during the day after Christmas when I got hit by the dude going up the hill, taking my daughter to the airport. Collision center kind of forgot about me. And my boy called me up and said, oh, sorry, man. So they're taking that in today, give me the estimate, and then see if that dude's insurance. But we'll find out today. So that's what we got going on. We got the Super Bowl this weekend. Rams versus the Bengals. It's going to be a good one. I would like for the Bengals to win because I like that Joe Burrow cat. And they got a good defense. A sleeper defense, let's say, because people didn't count them out, let's just say. And then you got the Rams, man. I think if they win, it's going to be a blowout. But if they lose, that means Bengals would win probably last second touchdown or a last second field goal. So that's my prediction. If the Rams win, they're going to win big. If the Bengals win, it's because they lost. I mean, they won at the last end of the game. That's the prediction. And also, I started a collection of jerseys not too long ago. I buy the winning quarterback's jersey of the Super Bowl. So, I got a couple more I got to get from the earlier ones. It's kind of hard to get those ones, especially when the quarterback is really a no name. So It is a little chilly out. It's supposed to, it's probably like almost, probably like 38 degrees. By the time it hits noon, it'll be around 50 though. That's crazy. We're in February. And they're saying probably we're not going to get any more snow either. See, last year we got a whole bunch of snow in February. Nope, we got our snow in January right at Christmas time, so I had it in my flex, I had to pay for it. But, yeah. Let's try to get some fish. So right now we're going to do a couple laps trolling around the lake. Counterclockwise. Nope, we're going clockwise. And let's see, and if I don't get nothing, then I'm gonna go ahead and park over there in my hot spot, and then see if we can catch some dropping some power bait down at the bottom. So on this rig over here, I have a I believe a pink wedding ring with no flashers, and over here I have a green hoochie with no flashers. So let me see if I can catch something on one of those. Oh, there's that guy with the canoe that pulled up next to me. He's over in that spot. Almost in that spot I drop anchor at. Well, he said this is his first time ever fishing this lake, so. So far he's, if he drops down to the bottom, he's in the right area. But if he's going to troll, he's in the wrong area. Especially when it's, for some reason, it comes out far too. It's very shallow over on that side. Over there. I'm talking about 4 or 5 feet shallow. I mean, it might be 7 feet now because the water level is high from all the rains and snow that we got in January. But still shallow. And not saying that you won't get any hits, it's just a lot of snagging, depending on how heavy your lure is. Oh. So March is coming around the corner. We'll be opening up our fall youth football and cheer registration. We'll be having trying to do combined teams again this year. And hopefully we'll have all the teams other than just the 7th, 8th grade team we had last year with a couple 6th graders. Hopefully we have the younger kids too, because I'll be the coach of one of the younger ones. Coach Brad is the 7th, 8th grade coach. I just got to find me one more coach for the 3rd team, so. It's really hard to find them dedicated people that have knowledge too, especially as a head coach. I mean, I could teach you, but then I would have to put you with the younger kids. But I'm hoping to get somebody that's got some experience. All right, now we're going to turn here and get some experience, you know. Yeah. Work is going good. I brought a bait in for the office. Now we got a pet. We're all in the process of naming it, so I told everybody to come up with some names. We'll put them in the hat, and then we'll draw the name. I like doing stuff like that. Then I got a lot of, I'm bringing food for the Super Bowl, so that my me and my coworker Mike can have a decent meal and watch some football. So like as I cross through this open space here, hopefully I nab a jumbo here, because that's how Brian got his. We were going across, if you remember. I think it was, I forgot what episode it was. We both got our PBs that day, but he had it going across here, and he had no flashers on his either. He was just the Rapala he used, the Rainbow Trout Rapala. And I can't remember if it was a floating or a sinking one either. But then I eventually used his while we hit the bot down there at the other end, and that's when then I hit. So, only time will tell, right? It is a little chilly, like I said, so. out. There's a boat right there. Got a couple people on there. Oh, maybe I should have put some contacts on. My glasses are fogging. They got a loud ass motor on theirs. Looks like the canoe guy is spot fishing. Looks like he's going out and throwing his bait in the water and jigging it in. I don't know if you can hear that motor from here. Well, let's go ahead and just sit back, relax, and let's hopefully we get a hit here. Yep, got a hit. I do. Got one. Yeah, son. Just caught it on the other side here. Awesome. It's not a gigantic, but it's a big one though, guys. All right. Oh, I had this lure out. All right, so it looks like I got him on the pink wedding ring. Oops. All right. The pink wedding ring. Right in the corner of the mouth. Nice hit. Nice catch. Alright. Yep, just right in the side of the lip. Perfect. Damn. Here it is. What do you think? It's probably about a 14 incher, maybe. We'll find out in a second here. Yeah, son. That's how it's done. Right. Cool beans. Let's get another one. That sounds done. About time, it's been a while. This is the first one I've caught, dropped the power bait. I was about to roll up and troll again. Yes. Took him a while. Hit on the green power bait.
Don't be
Yeah. It's about the same size as the first one I caught. Oh. Looks like I broke the hook off in him. All right. Oh, he's got a lot of little worms. He's been eating on little worms in there. Nice. Little worms at the bottom of the threw up all these little worms. So now I know what he's eating down there. And he's means he's feeding at the bottom. Awesome. Alright, so let's get him on the stringer. There we go. Same size as the other one. Let's go ahead and do some power bait dough.
Come tomorrow.
All right, the color I'm gonna use. It's gonna be the rainbow. Oh, got another one. Got another one. Yep, got another one.
Well,
yes, sir. Oh. Yep, got another one. This one's on the power bait dough. Yes, son. That's how it's done. Looks like they're biting. Not the jumbos, though, that they put in here. But I'm still getting some decent size, guys. It's awesome. About 13-incher. Yes, son. Yeah, son. Oh, I don't think he's there no more.
Is he?
Yes, he is. He's still there. Still got him. Still got him. Still got him. Nice. Nice. That's a big guy, too. Nice. Yes, sir. That's how it's done. Finally. Might be the biggest one out of them all. Maybe, maybe the same size. Just a tad bigger. Does look thicker though. Nice. Yeah, just a tad longer. We'll find out.
But they're primarily have been around the same size, around 14 inches. Not bad. Great eating size. Can't argue with that. All right.
All right, so that's four. One more to go. Let's get it. Yeah, son.
Oop, got fish.
Got a fish.
Yeah, I'm tugging on that. Yeah, sir. That's how it's done. Got another one.
This is the biggest one I caught all day, and it's the last one. That's our limit right here, guys. Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, big guy, too. Not the biggest I pulled out of here, but biggest of the day. Oh, look at that. Hooks out of his mouth too. That means he was caught in the lip. Nice.
Well, let me roll on this other one before I catch anything on that because we have a limit. What a way to end the day. Right. I was just about to rig up my trolling unit with another with a wedding ring. I saw a pole move out of the corner of my eye. All right, let's get a nice... Look at this fat bag boy. Oh, yeah, he's the biggest. Ooh, yeah. I'm having a hard time getting a hold of him.
This guy, that's a big boy. He's about 16, 17 inches. Nice. Yeah, son, that's how it's done. All right. Let's get him on the stringer. Yeah, let me show him off one more time, guys, how I got him on here.
Look at this guy. Wow.
Big. That's a big guy.
That's what I was after today. All the other ones are like 14 inches. This one's,
hold on, we can measure him right now. Now that I put that on. That ruler right here. And a half.
This bad boy was 16 and a half inches. Nice. Yeah.
All right, guys, that's it for today. We got our five. Last one being that big 16 incher. The other four were 14 inchers, and it was a great day. Spent about 5 hours out here, so about a fishing hour, you know. Caught two almost back to back, but there was some dry areas in there where I didn't catch nothing. And,
We also started trolling again and didn't get nothing on that one. But did catch one on the first one on the troll over to the spot. So, like I said, it was a great day. Sun finally came out. Also had to change the hat because it did get cold. But it just kind of pierced the troll. But we're going to go ahead and pack it up. Call it a day and then get home, clean the fish, and then batter them up and fry them. Till then, yeah, son.